Scientists say that there is evidence that there was liquid water on Mars, and there may still be some water underground.
And this discovery comes from samples that were collected during a four-year mission to Mars that ended in 2022. Joining us now is Vashan Wright from UC San Diego Scripps Institution of Oceanography. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
So what evidence is there that water existed and may still be there?
Yeah, so we know there is ice on the poles. If we look at the rocks and the sediments on the surface of the planet, it tells us that Mars once had lakes, rivers, and possibly oceans on the surface. And what we've done is that we've taken a look at how fast the speed of seismic waves that Mars quakes and impacts create, and the gravity. We take a look at both of the data and said, what is the thing that, what type of rock, how much water would need to fill it to match that data? And what we found is that liquid water filling the cracks of rocks from 10 to 20 kilometers beneath the surface is what's most consistent with the data.
So we had a Mars lander that was on a four-year mission, right? Mm-hmm. And it dug underneath itself, is that correct? To kind of learn what was around it, is that right?
Yeah, so there was a Mars lander, and that lander brought with it a seismometer.
Okay.
That seismometer is sensitive to listening to the vibrations in the ground. And so when a Mars quake occurs or an impact occurs, those waves travel from the source and mm-hmm. all the way to the lander. It shakes that seismometer, and depending on how fast it arrives there, the amplitude of the waves, etc., we can tell you how the speed of seismic waves change as a function of depth in Mars' surface.
One of the most amazing things is when, you know, they look at exoplanets
yes.
that are however many trillions mm-hmm. of miles away. They're like, well, it looks like it has oxygen or whatever it has. How do you figure that out? So the question is, obviously you had to study this and you're an expert. How do you figure these things out, come to these conclusions that 3 billion years ago there was water here and mm-hmm. and this Mars quake equals, you know, X. How does that all work?
Yeah, you know, geologists on Earth are like detectives. We mm-hmm. look in the rock mm-hmm. record. If you go to a river, you've probably, and it's dry, you've probably seen the cobbles on the surface. You go to the edge of an ocean, the water leaves marks. It mm-hmm. leaves history in the rocks. And from those histories, you kind of read the tea leaves, you can tell there used to be water at that place. And so that's one of the key evidence that there once was water. And from this study, it's how fast does seismic waves travel, because how fast it travels depends on what the rock is, what the cracks are like. Is there liquid water in the cracks?
Wow.
So how could this affect or benefit future manned missions to Mars?
You know what? It would be really hard to get this water. We're talking about water at 10 to 20 kilometers below the surface. And so on Earth, if you want to get water, and you want to drill very deep, sometimes you circulate mud or some sort of liquid water to make mm-hmm. the drilling easier. You need the power. You need all of those things. So that would be challenging. Right. You'd have to look somewhere where there's stuff coming from underground.
So 10 to 20 kilometers, 6 to 12 miles, is that right?
Yeah.
So is it possible life lives,
right.
exists somewhere below the surface of Mars, or are we getting kind of too in the weeds there?
You know, that's the million-dollar question.
Yeah.
What we do know is that on Earth, there is microbial life deep in the subsurface of Earth where there is water and a source of energy.
Hmm.
For this, what we now know is that the ingredients for life as we know it exists in the deep subsurface of Mars, 10 to 20 kilometers, and so it's potentially habitable.
So was there life on Mars? in your opinion?
I want the answer. My study says nothing about whether or not there is or is not life. But astrobiologists and others will be able to, you know, study this, and hopefully they're excited.
Yeah. How quickly and how, you know, I guess deeply are we able to understand these facts that questions we're asking? Maybe not facts, but at mm-hmm. least presumptions. Where, you know, we landed a lander on Mars, I don't know how many, 20 years ago, probably?
Yeah.
Something like
yeah.
that, okay? Or for the first time, I'm saying, maybe 20 years ago. We slowly added more and more, and this one came in 2018 to 2022. How much more data have we been able to gather through the last couple of decades where we kind of were just guessing at a certain point a long time ago?
Yeah, you know, the InSight team, for example, has done a tremendous job. It took decades mm-hmm. of work to actually get this approved, get the lander up there safely. and we didn't know how thick the crust of Mars was, what was the core like of the planet like we do on Earth, and now we have insights into all of these things. And so before we knew nothing about that stuff, or we knew some things but not very well. Now we have way better idea on how the planet formed, what's beneath there.
Well, with the technology and how we're advancing so quickly, that answer that, you know, may be just a few years away.
That is the hope.
Yeah, will this contribute to where NASA, for example, or whatever company does it first, tries to land humans in the years to come?
You know, I think NASA find out today, like the rest of the world. And so I do hope it inspires where the science goes next. Yeah. And we'll see.
Well, we appreciate you coming on, Vashan. Yeah. We have so many questions, but we appreciate you. Thank you.
Congrats on the study and the good work, and we look forward to more.
Thank you.
Come back and talk to us.
Appreciate you so much.